Good afternoon. Welcome to First Wayne Street United Methodist Church. I'm Dr. Geoffrey North, and it is my distinct pleasure to play some what I think are lovely and delightful pieces on the wonderful Beckerath organ as part of our 50th anniversary celebrations of this instrument. As always, thank you so much to all of our most generous sponsors who have helped support this concert series for 40 plus years now. These concerts have always been and always will be free and open to the public. So thank you so much to those who have given to this current season and all previous seasons as well. So now I'm going to play for you the Bolero de Concert.
Thank you.
So Louis James Alfred Lefebure-Wely has about the longest name that I'm aware of for classical organ composers. And although he was considered during his time to be one of the finest organists in Paris, his compositions did not have the same kind of esteem as many of his other colleagues because they were not as serious as you could hear in that piece, right? It's quite a charming piece. Bolero, if you don't know what that is a dance. It's not just a very famous, very difficult piece for snare drum by Maurice Ravel. So I hope you heard some of that dance motions in there. You can hear kind of the castanets and the guitars, and the bolero was commonly danced in Europe, and especially Spain in the mid-1900s. The next piece that I'm going to play for you by Dietrich Buxtehude is a preludium that is basically what's called the Stilus Fantasticus. It's in the fantastic style. And this will alternate sort of free sections, and then there is a fugue, a fugal section towards the second half of the piece. Buxtehude was considered one of the finest mid-Baroque Germanic composers and was especially admired by Bach, who famously left his job against his employer's wishes and walked, I think it's supposed to be about 200 miles by foot, so he could go and hear the master and study from the master in person.
Thank you.
So the Bach piece is chorale prelude. Chorale preludes were this sort of particularly Lutheran contribution to the repertoire. It began in the late Renaissance, early Baroque period, and was a way to introduce hymns. This hymn, Liebster Jesu, wir sind hier, Blessed Jesus, we are here at your word, and it's actually a hymn that's in the Methodist hymnal, as well, of course, in any Lutheran hymnal. So I'm going to play the hymn tune for you, because what Bach does to it is, I think, quite magical. He takes what is a very sort of simple, straightforward chorale, and he ornaments it very beautifully. It's very highly decorated to the point that if you don't know what tune it is, you probably would not recognize it. It's so so ornamented. So here it is, Liebster Jesu, wir sind hier.
Thank you.
I'll be impressed and quite surprised if any of you have heard of this next composer. If you have, come let me know after the recital. I did not hear of Nicolas Wolleb until a couple of weeks ago. I was just randomly watching organ YouTube videos, because that's what organ nerds like me do sometimes. And YouTube just played this one next after one of the other videos that I played. It's a Baroque style piece in the same sort of stilus fantasticus that we heard in the Buxtehude piece. You will hear some sort of free contrapuntal sections with flourishes and everything else. There are two fugues in this piece, but this composer is, to the best of my knowledge, still alive. He is a Swiss composer. He was born in the 1970s. I don't know if he's a professional composer or an amateur or what he does. I tried to find some other information about him online, and other than a handful of scores that he personally uploaded to an internet score repository, IMSLP, I can't find really any other information about this composer. Wish I could tell you more, but I think you will agree it's a really delightful, very Baroque sounding, even though it's not strictly from the Baroque period, piece of music.
Thank you.
Paul Manz, the composer of this next piece, was a Lutheran cantor, an organist, and composer. I knew him as an organist in Chicago. I mean, I knew of him. I didn't know him personally. But I have been to the church that he was the organist at and heard the organ there. I believe it's a Schlicker, if I'm remembering correctly, at that church. And this piece, this aria, shows off a couple of my favorite mutations on this organ, and so I hope you enjoy this aria by Paul Manz.
Thank you.
Thank you so much for coming out today to hear some organ pieces on my favorite pipe organ in town, this wonderful von Beckerath organ. Please be sure to come out next week to hear Michael Dulock, the Fort Wayne Cathedral organist. He will be playing the last of our Wednesdays on Wayne Street for this October. And then on Sunday, November 10th, not a Wednesday, Sunday, November 10th at 3 o'clock in the afternoon, we are going to have a 50th anniversary hymn festival. The First Wayne Street Choir will participate, as well as former First Wayne Street organist Irene Ator, some of the choirs from Purdue Fort Wayne, as well as Philharmonic Brass will all be here. It will be a wonderful celebration. You'll get to sing some hymns and just listen, so kind of consider it like a participatory concert. Again, thank you so much for coming out today. I'm going to leave you with some more Lefebure-Wely, the Sortie in E-flat.